say a few words. When I was a student at Yale, I taught trumpet on the side. And I'd like to tell you a story about a student I had who had had 1 year of class trumpet, and he had a range of about an octave. He knew the fingerings, he could read notes and simple rhythms, about what you would expect from that experience. And his father wanted him to have private lessons, so I started teaching him, and it was fairly obvious early on, like maybe after 3 weeks, that he had serious problems. And I was ready to suggest that he play trombone, maybe switch. I mean, that's kind of a typical thing to do. From my point of view, he did not have a bright future on the trumpet. But his father was determined not only that he continue in the trumpet, but that I'd be his teacher. So I continued. After several months of study, I noticed something that was really surprising, and that is the student was actually getting worse. I also noticed we had these little recitals that they would play, and at one of them it suddenly became clear to me that there was a sense in which he was amazingly good. It was true that no one ever knew what he was going to do next, but you did know that it was going to be very complex. And it was certainly the case he could do a lot of things that I could not do. I then had the odd idea that it might be interesting to see how interesting he could become. Or some people would say how bad he could be. I knew that if I wanted to take him down that road, that my problem would be primarily motivational. How do I keep he and his father coming back when he gets progressively worse? So I had to, I used the usual teaching methods. I had to say things like, it's going to get worse before it gets better. No pain, no gain, there's a big improvement just around the corner. Periodically, I would demonstrate. And so, you know, if you're a good player, you must be a good teacher. That kind of thing kept it going for quite a while. After 1 year of studying with me, he had an extremely airy and inconsistent sound. His sound, it wasn't always there. It would come in and out. He had unbelievably complex attacks. He had a range of about a minor third at point. And one of the things that impressed me the most was that he was no longer certain of the fingerings for the notes. In the meantime, I had become, well, I had begun experimenting with it. What I was trying to do was to see if I could do what he could do. And I wasn't very good at it, to tell you the truth. It always sounded like I was trying to sound bad and failing. And usually what I did was just too obvious, and it did not have the kind of subtlety that he had in his playing. Shake it.